In this video, we are going to discuss Scala strings. We know that strings can contain alphanumeric characters and also some special characters. In Scala, as in Java, a string is an immutable object, that is an object that cannot be modified. And on the other hand, objects which can be modified will be known as the mutable objects. As example, we can consider arrays. Strings are very useful objects in the rest of the section, and we present important methods of this java.lang.string. So there is the respective package name, there is the respective class name. So java.lang.string class, and Scala strings can be defined either in this way or in this way. Here you see var greetings is equal to hello world. You can find that here I didn't mention the type, the data type of this greetings, but as Scala supports type inferences, so that's why its type will be treated as a string, because the value which is getting assigned on this variable is known is of the type string. Otherwise, you can explicitly mention that var greetings of the type string is equal to hello world enclosed within double quotes. To have the better clarity on this Scala strings, let us go for one practical demonstration where you will be showing some sample codes and explanations and executions for your understanding. So here is the demonstration. In this session, we shall discuss Scala strings, and we shall discuss that how to define, how to create one string, how to find its length, how to create a formatted string and concatenation of the string. So let us go one by one with some sample coding. So here we have defined one myCity, one variable myCity with var. We have defined initialized with Calcutta. So like Java also, in case of Scala, the string will be enclosed within double quotes. The string will be enclosed within double quotes, and string can contain alphanumeric and special characters. So here you see, as we have defined this myCity with var, so that's why we have assigned Calcutta at first, and later if I want to change that one using Kolkata, update that one, so that update is possible. But if I put some value which is not matching of that string type, then obviously that will produce some error message, because myCity is meant for to hold some string value, not an integer. So if I define my place with a val, then obviously it is immutable. So I've defined this my place with val. So initialize with Calcutta initially, there is no problem. But if I want to go for reassignment, then error is coming. So error message is reassignment to val. So that's why it is immutable. But if you define the string with var, the string variable with the var, then obviously it is mutable, can be updated later on. So the string variable can also be defined mentioning explicitly the data type as string. So just look at the syntax. So we have used this one. Now let us concentrate how to find out the length of a string. So the functions are there, inbuilt functions are there, with the help of which you can calculate the length of a string. So you can find that here the length of my home is 8. Why my home is 8? Because my home is containing the string Calcutta at the end. So that's why it is having 8 characters. So the my home is having the length 8. Calcutta is also having the length 8. So instead of using the string variable, also you can mention the string enclosed within double quotes and then dot membership operator length function you can directly apply. For this null string, the length will be 0. For this blank space, the length will be 1 here. So we have discussed up to this. Now let us go for the concatenation. So here we are going for adding two strings. So that is a string concatenation. So see what we are getting here. We are having this Calcutta.concatenate university. So as a result of that, we are getting Calcutta University, but that is no blank space. So what we are doing, concatenation, blank space and university. And then we are doing this concatenation. So blank space and university are getting concatenated. And then Calcutta and with this concatenated string are getting done. So ultimately, I'm getting Calcutta blank space university. I think it is clear to you. So at first, this blank space and concat university is taking place. So we are having one blank character at the beginning of this university after doing the concatenation. Then Calcutta and that very string, resultant string, will be concatenated. So ultimately, I'm getting this Calcutta blank space university. Okay. Now we shall be discussing how to find out, how to print the respective formatted strings rather, how to do the formatting. So here we are having some set of examples. So let me run them.
Okay, now see what example we are having here. So here we are having this particular string, so that is our var. So var x int y int z int, and here we are having this is equal to 11, 22 and 33. So what will happen, this 11 will be going for this x, this 22 will be going for this y, and this z will be having the value 33. So we are passing multiple values at the same time, and then we are initializing them in the respective variables. So they have got initialized in this way. Now how to print them? We can print in this way: x is equal to percentage d, y is equal to percentage d, z is equal to percentage d. Then we are mentioning this one as x, y, z, and here we are using the function printf. So it is quite similar with the C programming or C++ programming also. So in case of C programming, we are having this printf function. Here in Scala also we are having the printf, and this syntax is very much common in C programming. So that is another way we are writing this one: x is equal to dollar x, y is equal to dollar y, and z is equal to dollar z. So here you should be formatting it as a string, so that's why s must be placed before that. So then we are getting x is equal to 11, y is equal to 22, and z is equal to 33. And the next one, we are having this float. This is a format we are having. So you are writing this one as x is equal to dollar x percentage 4d. So here this f stands for format, this s stands for string here. So here we can mention the respective format, in which format this dollar x is going to get printed. So here we have put percentage 4d, the value of 11, value of x is equal to 11. So it is printing two blank spaces, and then 11 is getting printed. But here we are having this 6, percentage 6d for y, but y is having the mere value, that is a 22. So four blank spaces are getting printed beforehand. And here it is percentage 5d, and we are printing z. So three blank spaces beforehand, then 33 is getting printed. So we have discussed that how to create formatted string in the output for the formatted output. So now we are going for the string and the ordinary string and the raw string. See what is happening. So here you can find that we have defined one str1. So this is str1 containing this slash t and slash n. We are having this slash t and slash n. But here we are defining the same, but here we are having this raw. So whenever you are printing this str1, then this slash n and slash t, they are having their respective outcome here. You can find out what is happening. So Scala, and then in the next tab we are printing this string, and in the next line we are printing this example. But whenever we are having this respective raw here, so what is happening? So now here the outcome is here, you can follow. So for the better visualization, so here we are having this slash t and slash n, they are getting printed. So this escape characters, that effects are not getting printed. Escape characters are those characters which will not get printed, but its effect will get printed if it is in ordinary string in case of Scala. But if it is a raw string, then itself the escape characters will get printed in the output. So in this session we have discussed a lot on the string, how to create, how to concatenate, how to get the length, how to print the formatted strings. So watch the next video for other aspects of the string. Thanks for watching this.